Mr. Horses. And I use him.
This is not my homework. It's estimates for my record company.
Ah, yes, which is the subject for this discussion, and I want your undivided attention.
What, are you rethinking investing, Ned?
No. I don't want you climbing into bed with Sonny Corinthos.
What is that supposed to mean?
It means there's no way in hell I'm going to let you and Lois get involved with Sonny. It's too dangerous.
I've been able to sleep almost any time in many places. Not here.
Tired, huh?
Yeah, I guess you can say that.
Well, I haven't had any luck catching Shaw either.
Small wonder, huh?
New heart is beating. So, I've got some things I have to take care of.
Hey. You were there in the OR, weren't you? In the transplant team.
Get out of my sight. Don't talk to me. Don't follow me. And don't ever touch me again.
General Hospital.
Bobby. So sorry. So sorry.
I can't do this. Not here and not now.
It's all right. I understand. Just, if there's anything you need, anything at all, let me help.
I cannot believe what I just saw.
You can't. Why not?
That was sick, disgusting, and despicable even for you, and you can't go on like this.
Or I can't. Why not?
Because I'm not gonna let you. The bet is off. I will not be a party to it one moment more.
Now, Lucy, this is starting to sound like a broken record.
Then why don't you listen this time? It has to end.
No.
You're not going to get off that easy this time. For God's sakes, Tony and Bobby's daughter just died. So you leave them alone. You don't put them through anything else because it's obscene. Leave them alone.
This is not the time or place to have this conversation. But since you are obviously so concerned, I was just leaving. You know, I'm sure you're about as welcome here as I am, so why don't you let me drive you home?
Bobby? You too. What can I say to help you? Oh, nothing. Thank you. Look, if I were in your place, I would be overjoyed by the miracle that saved Maxie. And part of me is so happy for you. But, being you really hurts. And it's kind of awkward for you, so would you mind if I left for a while? Of course not. Of course not.
Darling, would you like me to go with you?
Hey, kiddo. Let's get some fresh air, huh?
Great. That's great, yeah.
Well, they have completed the transplant procedure and the heart is in place and beating. The surgeons are closing now. The word so far is very good. No hyper acute rejection.
What's that?
Well, in a small number of cases, the heart is rejected immediately by the body. It's a terminal reaction.
But that hasn't happened yet.
No, 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 it hasn't happened yet.
Felicia must be very relieved.
Mm-hmm.
She's dead, Luke. She was dead before they ever got me. I couldn't save her.
I know.
And everybody's so happy about Maxie. But all I can think about is PJ lying there. I'm all alone.
But what else is wrong?
Oh, everything.
Oh, Ruby, I am so sorry. If there's anything Steve and I can do, please call us.
Thank you.
Let me do that.
Is there anything that you need? Is there anything you can do?
No.
I can't believe it, Bobby. I just can't believe it.
I don't. I can't either.
Where's Tony?
I don't know.
I suppose you're going to hear it all anyway, so better sooner than later, I guess.
Yeah.
I don't know where to start.
The beginning.
Well, tried to warn me about Damien, and I just wouldn't listen.
So,
right before they brought PJ into the ER, I was with Damien in the stairwell.
Why?
We were in each other's arms. Actually,
We were all over each other. And Tony found us, and he got really angry. And maybe if we'd just had a few minutes for him to yell at me, or for me to yell at him, just a few seconds even, everything might have been different. But right after he found me with Damien, Amy came to tell us about PJ.
Damien Smith needs strangling. I volunteer.
I was an active willing partner.
Barbara, we get the picture.
What has Tony said to you since then, Bobby?
Nothing. He's made it very clear he doesn't want to speak to me. He doesn't want to be in the same room with me. He doesn't want me to touch him.
Do you know where he went?
No. Did you try to find him? He needs somebody.
I'm sure he couldn't have gone very far. I'll see you later.
What were you thinking? What were you thinking?
I don't know. It's too late to worry about it now anyway. I'm starting to realize that my marriage and my family and the life I knew, the life I wanted, is gone.
One of the nurses said you would be down here.
Yeah, make some plans for a memorial for BJ.
You all right?
Well, nothing's ever gonna be all right again.
Look, I know you have your own way of dealing with things. Relentlessly positive. But remember, you know, time heals. Problems go away.
This won't go away. No matter how much I want it to, it's not gonna go away.
Tony. Now listen to me, I'm your brother. And I love you. Now, whatever's happened with Bobby, you can work it out. You both suffered a loss that is not even comprehensible to most people. I don't want you to be alone. Not now.
You know, I appreciate what you're trying to do, but in this case, you're wrong.
Tony? I'm sorry.
Oh. I didn't realize how much I needed that. You remember my brother?
Oh, yes, yes, of course. It's nice to see you again.
Right, you too.
I wish it was under better circumstances.
So do I.
I'm gonna head back down to ICU.
Okay.
Nice seeing you, Laura.
Bye. I can't even begin to imagine how you must feel.
No, you can't. And it's a blessing.
Well, what do you want?
I don't know.
Barbara, you're the only one who can straighten out this mess. You better decide what you want, and you better decide fast.
Well, I can't straighten out anything if Tony's not going to speak to me.
Too convenient. Do you want him to speak to you?
Of course I do.
So what do you want him to say? It's all right, it never happened, forget it? You'll go back the way you were before?
Yeah. No. I'm not sure.
Barbara, you don't have a lot of time here. You've got to decide. Now, Dr. Jones is a rational man. If you're honest with him, I believe he'll listen. But you've got to decide. You've got to decide what it is you want. Now, I ask you again, what do you want?
I don't know. I can't think right now.
Pull yourself together, Barbara. If you don't think, if you don't act now, there may be nothing to say when you finally wake up and take a look around.
Well, he'll never understand.
I asked you what the scam was with Dr. Feelgood. Do you remember?
Yeah.
Yeah, I couldn't believe that this wildcat I left behind had turned into a declawed house kitten when I wasn't looking.
get everything I always wanted.
Yeah? Did you? Did you? Then why Damien?
I don't know. Will you stop it, please?
I'm sorry, Barb. Listen. Whatever you decide, I'm on your side. Barbara, whatever you do, whatever you choose, I'm with you. And nothing will ever change that.
Promise, nothing.
Promise.
I didn't say anything. Were my thoughts getting too loud?
You must have.
I was thinking that, as horrible as this is, at least something good came out of it.
Yeah, Maxie has a chance for life.
Because BJ's gone.
I was there, you know.
Where?
In the OR when they took her heart. And the team seemed to be everywhere. It was a sort of a controlled frenzy. There was noise all over the place, monitors, ventilators, and the orders, and even feet moving around. And then Monica lifted her heart out, and I saw it. I saw it just for a few seconds. And then everybody left, and it got very quiet. It was incredibly quiet, except for the cardiac monitor. And I had never really noticed that sound before. It was the sound the flat line makes. It was like somebody was crying. And I reached up and I turned it off. And she was lying there. It was like she was asleep. It was like nothing had ever happened. And then it was finally, truly silent. And I think that was when I knew.
When you finally knew what?
Oh, that BJ was dead. She'd been dead when they brought her into the ER, but I hadn't.
You couldn't admit it?
I couldn't feel it. Well, I still don't want to.
Well, so far so good. Dr. Moulton is closing right now, and the prognosis is excellent.
When can I see her?
Well, she's going to be in recovery for at least 4 hours.
And then what?
Then we bring her down, and you're going to be amazed at what you see.
Why, is something wrong?
Oh, no. Her heart engaged immediately. I'm talking about her coloring. Her cheeks are rosy. Her fingers, her fingernails are nice, healthy things.
Oh, you must be exhausted. Sit down, please,
yeah.
Please.
Thank you. Yes, actually, I feel like I've been on my feet for about a week. You know, as many times as I have done this procedure, it still will remain undeniably a surgery's great miracle.
It sure seems like it to me.
When we suture the veins and the arteries and that heart is just lying there, it's limp, it's lifeless. You can't imagine, you can't believe that it could possibly ever work. And then that moment comes where you release the clamps and the blood flows, and all of a sudden it warms up. It just revives. It starts pumping. Physicians see a lot of inexplicable things. Some are good and some are bad. And I can tell you everything about this procedure, why everything works. And yet it will always be nothing less than a miracle.
So what now?
Well, now we keep an eye on her and look for signs of infection or organ rejection.
No, no, I refuse to believe that this won't work after everything she's been through.
No, I wouldn't worry. I don't think there's any reason to hope for nothing but the best. So I'll go take a look at her and I'll check back with you when I know something.
Okay.
Thanks.
You're welcome.
Look, it looks like things are on hold here for a while. Why don't I take you home and I'll stop by the Outback and see if I still have a business.
Sure, Uncle Mark.
Okay. I'll check with you later.
Okay.
Okay.
Bye.
So what now?
Brenda, this whole scheme will do nothing but get us all into trouble. And no matter how much that idea appeals to you, you aren't playing with fire. You'll go up in smoke.
I'm getting into business, not trouble.
Lois told me that you were planning to let Sonny bankroll this record label. I can't believe it. Sonny is a gangster. Do you have a single brain cell still functioning? You'll go to jail. Have you heard of the RICO Act?
You seem to be pretty comfortable doing business with Frank Smith's son.
Excuse me. Damien has been investigated, searched, probed, audited from here to Sunday. He has no financial links to organized crime.
Right. None you can find. And there'll be no links here either. Sonny is investing the profits from his club. They're legit.
Yes, and if you believe that...
I don't really have to believe that, because Sonny can hire hotshot lawyers to prove that he's clean, just like Damien Smith did. And what is the big fuss? Are you jealous?
This isn't about Damien. It's not about Sonny. This whole plot is your way of pushing me into a commitment with Lois.
That'd be a bonus.
But it's gonna backfire, little sister. I'm well aware that you two can be successful with or without me.
Oh! Finally, the man acknowledges someone else's intelligence besides his own. Let's go grab a pen and write this down.
Brenda! Listen to me. The closer you and Lois get, the more you push her to invest in Eddie Main and the Idle Rich, and the faster this whole situation is going to come to a head. And no matter how much I'm enjoying this, I'm gonna have to give up the band. No Eddie Main, no Idle Rich, no band for you to launch this record label with. So grab a pen and write that down.
This may come as a great shock to you, Ned, but the whole universe does not revolve around you. And I am in this thing for a whole lot more than the thrill of seeing you all cuddly with Lois.
Fine. Then don't put me in a position where I have to choose between music and ELQ. Not now. Not yet.
No matter what, I now have long-term plans with Lois Cirillo. From the sounds of things, longer-range plans than yours.
No, I would like to have long-range plans with Lois, okay? But I need time.
Get real, Eddie. Make it work. Make things happen the way I am. You know, if you're having trouble with Lois, it's probably because you've deceived her from the word go. Listen, I'm gonna have a business. My business. With your approval or without your approval. I don't really care which. Because from now on, Ned, your personal life is your business. Fix it. Ignore it. Do whatever you want. But don't ask me to give up what I want. Because it might mess up this little game you're playing.
I bet you haven't been out of this hospital room since Maxie's been a minute, have you?
Hi.
Well, that's going to change right now. I think we ought to get out of the building for a while, huh? Fresh air.
Oh, no, I can't. I have to.
What do you have to do? I mean, there's nothing that you have to do, Felicia. She's in recovery right now. She has the best medical staff watching her. There's absolutely nothing that you have to do for her. I have it on best authority now. Now, come on, let's get out of the building and get some fresh air, huh? What do you say?
First go,
No arguments, Felicia. I want to go out, go for a walk, fresh air. Now, don't make me carry over my shoulder like a child, okay? Out. Now.
I feel enormous sympathy for Bobby, that I think Tony is treating her terribly? Or could it be that it's okay to seduce Bobby on certain days and not on others?
No, even you can't be that cold-blooded. Their child just died. What kind of person would exploit a tragedy like that?
How am I being exploitative? I care about Bobby very much. And I just can't walk away. I mean, there's obviously a serious rift between Tony and his wife. And if he's not going to be there to give her the emotional support she needs, then I will be gladly.
No. No, you won't.
What does your delightfully devious brain have cooked up?
I'm going to hit you in the only place you have any feelings at all. Your wallet.
Well, how do you plan to manage that?
Well, my dear pal, I am going to withdraw my support from you at the next ELQ board meeting. That's right. Edward would love to have my vote. So it's very simple. You have a choice. You either leave Bobby and Tony alone, or you stand to lose an astonishingly large amount of money.
Miguel. I'm so glad I found you.
What are you doing here, Miss?
You've been on my mind all day. You and the children you pulled from the van. Are they okay?
Two of them are still in the hospital. They'll be fine. Now, one little girl, the one I went back into the
before the explosion.
Well, she was brain dead when she got to the hospital.
Oh, no, Miguel. Poor baby. What about her parents?
Well, her parents did a very generous thing.
What was that?
They donated her heart for a transplant. In fact, it'll probably save the life of the little girl who's focused on this place.
Do you realize that that's another life you saved?
Mary May, I hadn't thought about it that way. Anyway, in my place, anybody would have done the same thing.
I hope you never know how wrong you are about that.
Miguel, what's the word?
Everything under control. Maxie.
Well, she's out of surgery. The new heart is working. And, we have to wait and see, but it's looking pretty good.
That's good. I want you to meet a very good friend, Mary May Ward, Max Scorpio.
How do you do?
Very nice to meet you. I've heard a lot about you, Mrs. Ward. I mean, you've helped more kids than most of us know in a lifetime.
And I've loved every minute of you. Was it your little girl who received the heart transplant?
No, no, it was my fiancé's daughter.
Has Miguel told you how he made that possible?
Well, no. What'd you do?
And there was gasoline everywhere. And the engine block was red hot. The driver knew it was going to explode. But Miguel went back in anyway and brought out the last little girl. Then the van blew. And the child in Miguel's arms, he now tells me, was brought to the hospital brain dead.
BJ. If you hadn't saved BJ, Maxie probably would have died too. Gil, why didn't you say anything to us?
Matt, what was there to say?
Well, I can see that he doesn't like to play the hero. But I hope you know just how grateful I am for what you did for us.
Well, I'll be happy if Max is able to go back home and be well.
Well, it's time I get back to the ward house. But it was very nice meeting you, Max. And I hope to see your little girl up and about really soon.
Thank you, so do we. And thank you very much for telling me about the accident.
I thought you would like to know. Take care, Miguel.
I wish you could have seen the look on Felicia's face when she heard Maxie came through surgery. I mean, then you'd know how much what you did means to us.
And that's enough for me. I just want her to get well so you and Felicia can get married and get on with your lives.
The life that you want? Is it what you thought it would be?
Yes. Yeah, it is. The work's complicated and dangerous, as you know, but a lot of people can't handle it. But I can. I do it well. The most important thing is I see the difference that I make.
Then you made the right choice.
Well, I guess I did.
So did I.
Doesn't mean that I haven't missed you.
Me too. Oh, if only you could see Maxie when she's well. She's the most wonderful little girl.
Well, it's easy to tell why. She has, great mother, perfect role model. Mac thinks so too. You know, he likes you a lot.
Oh, yeah, he does. And he's crazy about Maxie.
Oh, that's good. I'm glad.
And you should know something too.
What?
Mac and I make sure she knows that you're her father, her real father.
Thank you. I appreciate that.
How is she?
Take her home, Rube. There's nothing she can do here. You'll stay with her? Ruby. No lectures.
You're right. Honey, sweetheart.
Yeah?
I'm gonna take you home with me.
Oh, no, Ruby.
I'm gonna take you home with me. I'm gonna put you to bed. And no arguments.
PJ.
Thank you.
Where's Bobby?
Ruby took her home. Did you find Tony?
Yes, I did. He's drawn so tight, he's about to break.
It's a mess. Mm-hmm. Each guy's dead, and it's like they're doing everything they can to throw their marriage in the grave after her. It's awful. It's like watching a train wreck.
There's nothing more you can do now, Luke.
Oh, honey. I need to do something. I need to hit something. I need to hurt somebody. Mm-hmm. But you can't. You can't fight that. You can't.
You always have for me. And won.
Take me home, Major.
Y sobre todo un deseo que mante de dejar mi mal y descifrarte.
I just realized something.
Ah! It's spring! Oh. I have spent so much time in the hospital. The last time I remember looking around, it was winter. It makes sense, though, you know, that it's spring. Seems like it takes such a long time for winter to go away. Everything dying, and just when you thought you'd given up hope, everything blooms and comes to life again. Like Maxie.